This is the timeline workspace, and you may notice that it has a few different toolbars that you may need in this workspace that you don't need in others. For example, here on the side is now a new toolbar we haven't seen before, which is the sound toolbar. Each one of these boxes represents a panel of our storyboard. You can see it looks a lot different than the thumbnails. If you need more room, because these are too small, if you just click in this area with the timeline, you could press the number 2 on your keyboard, and then the panels will get bigger so that you have an easier time interacting with them. This bar at the top represents the timeline of your storyboard, and this bar right here represents the camera move that we just created. You can see that the line it's sitting on is labeled camera over here on the left. The diamonds represent the keyframes. This is the keyframe at the start of the panel, and this is the keyframe at the end of the panel. This red bar is the playhead, and if you click on this red bar and you drag it to the left or you drag it to the right, then you're moving either forward in time or backward in time. And you could see already that when I'm scrolling or scrubbing over the panel with the camera move, that I can see it move. You'll also know that the image jumped forward, because when I'm scrubbing, it lets me see the image at full size, a way that you can see even more clear representation of what it will look like on the screen. You could click on the camera mask, which again does not affect the artwork when it's output, it just helps you to see it better. So this way I can see what it will look like. I can see if the framing is exactly what I want it to be. You can move these keyframes along the camera move bar by clicking and dragging. So if I click on this, I can move this keyframe so that it doesn't start at the beginning of the panel. Let me show you the difference now. I'll grab the playhead. And now when I scrub through that panel, the camera move doesn't start until halfway through. I still feel like I need more room, so I'll click the number 2 on my keyboard so that I can really work in this panel. So I can click and drag the start position during the time that it's going to take, and I can also click and drag the end position. And in this way, the camera move will happen in the middle of the panel rather than all the way through it. I'm going to click back out with the number 1 key, and there is a scroll bar at the bottom to help you move through the panels. If I click on any panel, the playhead jumps right to the place that I clicked. If you want to move to the first frame or the last frame, you could go up into the toolbar, and one of the toolbars will let you click this button to go to the first frame, and that could be very helpful when you need to put your keyframes at a specific place.